Hello, welcome to the first in a series of four videos on doing a systematic review. These videos are aimed at students, undergraduates and master's students who may be asked to do this type of review for their project. In this first video, we'll be looking at what is a systematic review and how does it differ from a literature review. We will look at finding some examples and also the steps involved in doing a systematic review. A systematic review is usually seeking to answer a specific question by looking at the results of existing studies published in the literature. It includes an extensive search to find relevant studies and involves developing a detailed protocol so that you can judge the relevance of those studies. It then evaluates all the relevant literature for inclusion and for quality, and includes a detailed write-up and recording of the methodology so that somebody else could come along and repeat that search and get the same results. A systematic review may also include a meta-analysis of the statistics taken from those studies. For more detailed guidance on all the steps involved in doing a systematic review, have a look at our guide. A systematic review fits in on the scale of literature reviews. The most basic level of literature review would include a summary of the literature, usually to try and support a predefined argument. It can also be used to identify gaps in the research that could be addressed by future research, and a basic literature review, the search strategy is not usually recorded. The next level of literature review is a systematic literature review, and as the name suggests, it's far more detailed and includes a comprehensive search of multiple sources. The search strategy used is usually recorded. This type of study can be done by one person and usually involves identifying a gap in the knowledge to come up with a research question. It is an impartial type of study, so there's no predefined argument. Whereas a systematic review, once again, is very comprehensive in its search and the strategy is recorded. But usually with a systematic review, you're looking to answer a specific question. There is a very explicit methodology for the search and the protocol details the inclusion and exclusion criteria. Because there's very detailed recording of the search strategy, it means it is reproducible. And with professional systematic reviews, these are usually done by a team to avoid bias. But obviously, if you're doing this type of study for your final year project, then it will just be you working on it with your supervisor's guidance. So the type of systematic review that would be done by a student would not be the sort of gold standard systematic review because it's being done by one person. This slide is just to draw out that in a bit more detail. So with a systematic review, you're bringing together results of studies to answer a specific question, whereas a systematic literature review is providing a subjective summary of the literature on a topic. A systematic review would include an extensive search covering both published and may also include grey literature. Whereas a systematic literature review would focus very much on the published literature and not include grey literature. A systematic review would have a very detailed protocol, often developed using a framework such as the PICO framework. And you can talk to your supervisor about what sort of framework you should use. Whereas a systematic literature review would just include a detailed search strategy. There wouldn't be a protocol. Now, usually a systematic review would involve three or more people to eliminate bias, whereas a systematic literature review could be done by a single person. And a professional systematic review can take months or years to produce, whereas a systematic literature review can take a lot less time. And as you can see from what you would include in the write-up, there's a lot more sections in a systematic review write-up to include the protocol, the search strategy, the review of the results against the eligibility criteria, evaluation of those studies, and interpretation and presentation of the results, which may include a meta-analysis. It would have a very extensive reference list covering both included and excluded studies, and detailed appendices showing the search strategies used on each database. Whereas with a systematic literature review, you'd normally have fewer sections, so introduction, the methods section would include the search strategies such as keywords used and databases searched, a discussion, a conclusion, and a detailed reference list again. You should discuss with your supervisor exactly what type of projects they're expecting you to do, just to make sure that you're both heading for the same result. If you're not sure what a systematic review is or how to draw up a protocol for a review, there are a couple of places you can look to find examples. The Prospero database gives systematic review outlines. And the example I'll show you in a moment is on the effect of blueberries on cognition and mood. And then the Cochrane Library gives you full write-ups of systematic reviews, so you can see exactly what goes into writing a professional systematic review and how that is laid out and how the appendices are used to record search strategy. You can find links to both Prospero and Cochrane on our systematic review guide. Just scroll down and on the left of the screen there's a box to find existing systematic reviews. Let's look at Prospero first of all. You can search Prospero by clicking on the search button on the right of the screen and pop in your keywords with the search operator and in between. That will search across all systematic reviews that have been registered as in progress or planned with the Prospero database. The one I just wanted to show you is at the bottom here. And this gives you an example of what your protocol should look like for your systematic review and the sorts of information you should be including. So the review question, which databases you're planning to search and your basic keywords, types of study to be included, what sort of condition is being studied, the participants, the intervention planned, the comparator, so is there a control group, and the outcome. So this is where PICO comes in, your participants, the interventions, the comparator, and the outcomes. So use Prospero to find examples of protocols that are being used to plan systematic reviews. If you're looking for a full write-up of a systematic review, you can find that on many databases will include systematic reviews, but the Cochrane Library has the gold standard systematic reviews in it, and they're produced to very strict criteria. So follow the link here through to the Cochrane Library and pop your search, your basic keywords in here. And you don't need to put the search operator and in between. It will just do that automatically for you. So my search has found me 9 full write-ups of Cochrane reviews and also 888 trials which are currently taking place related to the keywords that I've typed in. Let's have a look at one in a bit more detail. Over here on the right you get a contents list so you can jump to a specific section. But have a look at a few review examples to get an idea as to how a professional systematic review is written up and what you need to include. So for instance, if we jump down to the methods section, you'll see the sort of PICO framework coming out here and also details of which databases they search to find their literature. And if we want to see a bit more detail about their search strategy, that is usually included in the appendices. And this is the way a professional search would be put into a database, searching for each individual word and then combining them, as we'll see in the later video. So use Cochrane to find examples of the sort of thing you're aiming for when you write up your systematic review. These are the steps involved in doing a systematic review. The first step is to draw up a protocol, using a framework such as PICO to help you come up with a list of inclusion and exclusion criteria to judge the relevance of the results that you're finding. You then need to choose where to search, which databases are going to be relevant for your study. develop a search strategy that will work on all of those databases and include as many different keywords and alternatives as you can think of, but still being relevant. Running and recording your search is the next step, so once you finalise your search strategy, you run your search on each database and download the results into a reference management system, and the one I'd recommend is Desktop EndNote. And you can then manage your search results in Desktop EndNote, and it can help you with step 6, which is evaluating and sifting the results, until you're left with hopefully a fairly small number that you're going to concentrate on in your write-up, which is the final step. You can find a lot more help about all of these steps in our systematic review guide shown on the right of the screen. Move on to the next video in this series to look at the first 4 of those steps. But if you need further support with your review, definitely discuss it with your supervisor. Make sure you're both on the same page when it comes to what type of project you're doing and whether you are actually doing a systematic review. Look at your project handbook, which should be available on Blackboard. Consult our systematic review guide if you are doing that type of study. And if you need more help, especially with your search strategy, choosing places to search and using EndNote, please do contact your academic liaison librarian.